Hello everyone, my name is Ashish. Welcome to my channel Options X. In this video, I'm going to talk about wall short trade ideation, as in how to identify wall short trades. In the last video that I did, I was told that my voice was not clear. So I'm using a headset this time. I hope it is much clearer this time. So let's start. So what do we mean by wall short? So when we say wall short, it means that we are shorting the volatility. And it is implied volatility that we are shorting. So we don't have a view on direction. It's mostly when we talk about wall short, we are taking delta neutral trades, wherein we don't have a view on direction, and it's just that we are shorting volatility, and in hope that volatility comes down and we make money out of that. So I'm going to cover some basics before I start how to identify wall short trades. So first of all is implied volatility. Implied volatility, or IV, is the percentage of any underlying by which a 1 SD move or a 1 standard deviation move is expected. So let's say a stock is trading at rupees 100 and the implied volatility for that is 30%. Now what does it mean? That there is a 68% probability, which comes from 1 standard deviation, that the stock will remain in the range of plus minus 30% of that stock price, which is 70 on the lower side and 130 on the upper side. So if a stock has 30% volatility, 30% IV, and the stock is trading at 100, there is a 68% probability that it will remain in the range of 70 to 130 over the period of next 1 year, because implied, when we talk about IV, it usually means we are talking about a year as a period. In the layman terms, if the IV of an option is high, it means that the option prices are high, and if the IV are low, if the IVs are low, it means that the options are priced in cheaper. It's dynamic and it keeps changing based on underlying movement. Today a stock might have an IV of 30, tomorrow if there is any news and the IV goes up, it might be trading at an IV of 35. But the very basic is, if the IV goes up, option prices will go up, and if the IVs come down, option prices will come down, assuming all other factors are constant. What is realized volatility? Now, while the implied volatility tells you how the market participants are factoring the future price movement of any underlying, the realized volatility tells you the magnitude of historical price movements over a period of time. So if you look at this chart which I have posted, it gives you IV as well as historical volatility of 30 days and 10 day period of the same underlying. So the purple one is IV, the green one is HV of 30 days, and the orange one is HV of 10 days. So we can see that how the realized volatility for both 10 days and 30 days, from a period starting this one till here, has been under the implied volatility. IV percentile and IV rank. So first, IV rank. IV rank is a measure of current implied volatility against the historical implied volatility range over a one year period. So it's a simple formula which we can use. IV rank is equal to current IV minus 52 week low, as compared to 52 week IV minus 52 week low. So we get the IV rank. So higher the IV rank means that the current IVs are higher. Lower the IV rank means that the current IVs are lower. Next one is IV percentile. As the name suggests, IVP tells you the percentage of time that the IV in the past has been lower than the current IV. So let's say if we have 252 trading sessions in a year, and we are saying that the current IVP is 70%, then it means that 70% of the time of those 252 days, the IV were lower than the today's IV. So its look back period is usually 1 year, just like IVR. I use IVP for my trading. You can use any of the two for trade identification, but it's just that you have to be consistent with whatever you use. I use IVP always. when I'm looking for a wall short trade. Now we talk about delta neutral wall short trading. So what are delta neutral short wall trades? These are short straddle, short strangle, short iron fly, short iron condor, or any other strategy which we can make using a combination of options along with equity and futures. So all these trades will have delta as zero when we start the trade, and we are shorting the volatility. We are shorting the high volatility which we are perceiving. When to initiate? Now strangles and straddles are something which we can do any period of time, but what I usually do is early on in the expiry, which is like 30 to 35 days to expiry, I initiate strangles. And later on in the expiry, I initiate straddles. The ATM options theta decay is faster in the later half of the expiry. That's why I try to do straddles slightly later as compared to strangles. Risk defined flies and condors can be taken anytime depending on one's view. Now, what are some of the criteria that I use for a wall short trade? So first one is shorting high IVs, not necessarily rising IVs, in general works, but it has to be seen along with the context of price movement. If the underlying is moving too fast, too soon, it's understood that the IVs will go up and might not be the best time to short the IVs when the underlying movement is zigzag and it is pretty fast. I use IBP as a filter, so IBP of greater than 70 is a good filter to start with. Sometimes I take trades which are for which IBP is even 60 or 55. It's not a very set in stone rule that we have to use, but yeah, IBP of greater than 70 serves as a good filter. Next, what you have to look at is how has the realized volatility been. So you can compare IV with the 10-day HV or 30-day HV. If the IVs are higher than the 10-day HV or 30-day HV, then it makes for a good trade. Next is when you are shorting falling IVs, it is usually a safer bet compared to selling high IVs. So if given a choice, I would like to sell falling IVs instead of selling very high IVs. The next thing which I look at is the credit which we are receiving on a trade. Is the credit enough which we are receiving on a trade so that, you know, there is sufficient premium which we are receiving upfront, and there is sufficient theta decay which we can get in a trade. Then we check what is the break-even range which we are getting as compared to the stock movement over the last few days. So let's say if stock is consolidating between 500 and 600 range, and if the break-even range that we are getting by shorting volatility is outside of this range, then it usually is a good trade to take. Is the underlying in consolidation or the move is one-sided? If the move is one-sided and because of which you are seeing the high IVs, then I would advise to not short those IVs in that particular stock. If the stock is in consolidation, then it usually means it can continue to be in a consolidation for consolidation going forward. So we can take a trade there. The last thing is trade small and trade often. We have to take small bets in many underlyings rather than taking one concentrated bet in one underlying. So that is the underlying principle which I use for my trading, and I take wall short trades in many underlyings rather than taking one concentrated bet in one underlying. Wall short trades, how do they work? All that we have discussed so far, it's just a guideline to figure out stocks that offer good opportunity on the short wall side. It's just a framework that I use, and these are not hard rules that I apply or recommend. They are high POP in nature, as in they have high probability of winning. So since the probability of winning is on the higher side, it works well if we combine it with the proper position sizing and risk management. It doesn't require you to do much of technical analysis, but I do look at horizontal support and resistance to make entry exit adjustment decisions. So say let's, for example, let's take the example of Nifty. Nifty has been consolidating in 15,500 to 15,900 range for the last 2 months. And if we are in that ball short trade, now once that 15,950 kind of a zone is taken on the upside, it's best to figure out, you know, it's best to get out of the ball short trades at that point in time. We can look for any other underlying wherein, you know, we can identify ball short trades. So that is something I look at, horizontal support and resistances to make entry and exit and even adjustment decisions based on that. Now, next thing is understanding of vol behavior definitely will give you an edge, and which is something which you will get, you know, after you gain some experience taking these trades. But more important than that is position sizing and risk management. You won't do too bad as long as you take care of these two things. So emphasize more on position sizing and risk management. Then trying to, you know, get a mastery on how the vol behavior changes. Higher IVP or lower IVP doesn't change probability of success much. It's just that when you put in trades in higher IVP, you receive higher credit upfront and you get paid more if you are right in high IVP environment as compared to low IVP environment, and of course you are taking that higher risk as well in that case. Very often you would see sudden IV spikes despite no news movement in the underlying, which usually get followed by IV crash. So if I see such a spike in any underlying without any news or without any stock movement, I usually take vol short trades in those. Now let's talk about position sizing. I plan to do a separate video on position sizing as to how I size my positions for my account and how one can go about size their positions in vol short trades. But for this video, I'll try to keep it short. Notional value. So I size my positions based on notional value and not based on margin required. So notional value is price of the underlying times the contract size. So let's say Nifty is currently trading at 16,000 and lot size is 50. So notional value is 16,000 times 50, which is 8 lakhs. Reliance current market price, let's say it is 2,000, lot size is 250. So its notional value is 5 lakhs. For naked option sellings that we do, say for example straddles or strangles, I carry about 2-3 times of exposure of my overall account. If you are starting out, if you are new to this kind of a trading, then you should strictly stick to 2x exposure and not more. Even for defined risk strategies which you do, like short condos, short flies, you should not take more than 3-4 times exposure, depending on what is the structure of your trades. So for a 20 lakh account, this is you know what I would advise, that trade only those underlyings which have notional value less than 7-8 lakhs, and carry overall 2x exposure in the beginning, which means it should be limited to 40 lakhs or a maximum of 5-6 stocks. For a small account size like 20 lakh, trade just one lot in each stock. Do not average out losing trades. I do it because of the larger account size, and I deploy my position in chunks. So I do that quite often. But for a 20 lakh account, I would not advise you to average out losing trades. The initial stop which we can keep for each of the shortfall position is 2 times the credit received or 2 to 2.5% of overall capital in one trade. For naked short option position, do not just sit out and wait for reversal. Say you have put on a strangle, you have sold 16,300 call and 15,700 put in Nifty, and market starts to move one side. Then don't just wait for trade to turn green and wait for reversal that the it has risen so much, how far it can go. Just always rebalance the delta as and when needed. I have done a video on strangle adjustments, which you can look at. Target minimum 25% of the credit received in each position, beyond which I take a call based on how my overall portfolio is looking, and if there are other opportunities available, I try to close some of the positions and take new ones. Do not force trades if the IVs are low and there are not much opportunities. Just sit on cash or trade directional through spreads. I remember in the last couple of months there were not many opportunities, so I was trading very less on naked vol short side. I think I was carrying around 1 to 1.5x exposure most of the time, not more than that. Let's now move to some of the trade examples for the vol short trades. Earlier I thought of putting some of the past trade examples, but then I thought I'll try to do this live. Okay, so I'm trying to do this live. We are logged on to Opstra and let's see if we can find an opportunity for a vol short trade. So first thing which we can do is figure out whether stocks have high IVP or not. So if you look at IVP, the IVP may not give us correct numbers because in the last year there were the IVs were very high. So IVP might not give us true picture. What Opstra has done is they have introduced this IVP cube, which is quarterly IVP. So we can sort on IVP cube. So I've sorted this on IVP cube and see if we can get a vol short opportunity. So now what we see is that most of the stocks that appear here, which have high IVP cube and high IVP, are the ones which have result. So these are all earning vol short trades, which we will take right before the earnings. So this video is not about putting on vol short trade for earnings. It's for non-event based vol short trades. So we'll look for some opportunity where there is no earnings to be declared. So these are some of the stocks that come to this filter. Coalpel, Torrent Pharma, IDFC First Bank, these are the stocks I don't do. We don't have much liquidity. UBL is again, sometimes it is liquid, sometimes it is not. So let's take a look at UBL. If you look at the chart of UBL, it had a fabulous run from almost 1000 to 1500, and there it had taken a resistance twice. First this time and then again here. So 1520 on the upside seems a decent level where we can put our call, and if you look at the downside, then this should act as a support, this 1316 level which we see. So it had taken resistance earlier here, then once more here, and from here it had given a breakout. So these are the strikes I should be looking at. Let's also look at the option chain of UBL. Now 1320 strike, the put delta is 15, which is fine. And if we go to call delta, 1520, okay, the call delta, we cannot have 1520 as our short strike. We can probably look at 1580 as our short strike. So 1580, 1320, these are the strikes we can look to short. Now let's see if we have liquidity here. So the credit which we are getting is about, okay, 1320 is not liquid, so let's look at 1500 instead. Yeah, this is fairly liquid. We can get a fill for rupees 8. and then call also we can move to 1600. Which is again trading for rupees 8.4. So we will get this strangle filled for around 16.4, 16.5 kind of a price, and the lot size is 700. So it will give us a credit of about 11,000, which is decent. So for this UBL wall short, we can see that after a good run up, it is now in consolidation. It is trading between 1480 to 1390. The strikes that we have chosen are almost 10% away. Call side is even further. So the break-even range is also good. The credit received is decent. It is not that great, but given we are now trading in low vol environment, so I'll take this credit. Another thing which we can look at before putting on this trade is how has the volatility been for UBL in past few weeks. So I'll go to UBL's IV chart. Okay, the results are also done with, so that is also a plus point for this trade. And then, the IVs have been, okay, let's do it on 10 days first. Yeah, so the HV for 10 days and 30 days is already below the implied volatility. So which is again, I mean, this is not a very hard criteria for me that enter only when IVs are greater than HV. But yeah, we can see that the HVs are now coming down. The historical, the realized volatility is not as much as is being factored in the implied volatility. So yeah, this looks like a good trade to take. So we can enter this trade. Let's see if we can figure if there are any other opportunities. So what this is just one way to figure out trades. What you can also do is you can look at the IV change, sorted by IV change, and see which are the stocks that have for which IVs have gone up today, and then see if there is any news or any event around those stocks, or if there is a sharp price movement because of which the IVs have gone up. So try to figure out from that perspective. For now, let's just stick to, and then I also look at the price change percent. You know, the stocks which are moving higher, generally they will see good IV run up as well. So going back to IBPQ criteria for now, is there any other stock where we can find another wall short opportunity? Adani Ports, the results were declared yesterday, but IBP and IBPQ both are not that great. I'm sure the credit which we will have on a 17-18 delta strangle will not be sufficient. Glenmark is another stock which we can look at. So it's trading at around 596. If you look at the chart of Glenmark. So if you look at the chart of Glenmark, it gave a sharp rally from 550 to almost 700, and then there is even a sharper decline within 3-4 trading sessions. It had come down to 585, and now it is trying to consolidate in this narrow range. So 600 and 580 kind of a range. So if you look at So if we look at Glenmark option chain, we see that 540 is 15 delta put. Even 550 we can consider is 19 delta. And then on the call side we have 675, which is odd strike. Maybe we can consider 670 and 550 strikes. Let's see 670 and 550. Again, this is not a very liquid stock to trade in. Sorry, not 570, it was 540 put. So this is trading for 5 rupees, 670 call. And this is again not very liquid. So we'll get around 9 rupees for this strangle. 9.5, and the lot size is 1150, which is which gives us a credit of around 10k. Now after this sharp decline, within the matter of 3-4 trading sessions, we should usually avoid such kind of stocks. You know, wait for a longer consolidation period before we put on trade in this. So I wouldn't really do this Glenmark, but yeah, UBL is something which I can do. And we don't have much opportunity otherwise. I'll try to do one more video when there is when there are more opportunities and see if it makes sense. Okay, I'm trying to do this live for the second day now. I just posted a trade on Twitter on LT wall chart. So let's look at LT chart first. LNT declared its result on 26th of July, which was here. Yeah, and since then it has been consolidating in a very narrow range. If we look at the chart prior to the result declaration, it had a sharp run up from 1500 to 1600 in the matter of a couple of trading sessions. And then it is kind of consolidating between 1650 on the upside and 1550 on the downside. If we look at the IV chart for IVHV chart for 10 days, we see that earlier historical volatility was higher, and which was kind of factored in because the moves were also there. We see LT rallying from 1500 to 1600, and now the result reaction is also done. We saw that results were declared on 26th, and after the result reaction the HVs have started to come down. If we look at the option chain and if we try to do a 1516 delta strangle here, then it will be 1540 on the put side and 1720 on the call side. The premiums which we will get is about 7 plus 8 15, which is about 9000 for this strangle. So that's why I chose to do a narrow strangle. And I'm bullish on LT in the near future, so I have chosen my put strike delta to be higher. I have sold 1600 1700 strangles, but the trade which I have posted on Twitter is a risk defined one. Again, the delta is on the higher side for that trade also. What else? Yeah, the reason I did not do a 1516 delta strangle here, because the credit received is not great. So although this is LNT, smaller underlying, as well as not smaller underlying, but since it doesn't move much, the options are not priced that higher. So that's why instead of doing strangles here, I had suggested to do an iron condor. While we are doing this, let's see if we get an opportunity or on another wall chart trade. So this is again dashboard. We had seen yesterday we had sorted on IBPQ and we did not find much trades. So what I've done is I have sorted this on IV change now. IV change in terms of percentage, and you know, because not much is going to change in IBPQ or IBP in the matter of just one day. So I've sorted it on IV change. The stocks that now are are coming on radar are Adani Enterprises, Reliance, Ambuja Cement and HCL Tech also. So let's look at some of these stocks. Let's look at HCL Tech first. HCL Tech has also declared results. So result reaction on HCL Tech is already done. So here we see HCL Tech is trading at around 1055. 15 delta is 990 and it is trading for 6 rupees. Again, not very attractive premiums to short. So I'll probably skip this one. Reliance, I know for sure that the premiums are very low since it has come to 2000 from 2400 levels in sometime last year. The next stocks that we had to see were Adani Enterprise and Ambuja. Let's look at Ambuja first. So I'm not sure if Ambuja has declared results already or not. Opstra is not showing. We can double check that. I don't think a result announcement has been made for Ambuja yet. So Ambuja is trading at 405. If we look at the chart of Ambuja, yeah, steep rally from 340 to 420, and then today it is down 3-4%. Yeah, so let's look at option chain of Ambuja. So 380 could be our put strike, and 440 could be our call strike. If you look at the high which it made here was 430, so 440 seems good strike to be short on, and here it might take a support because it rallied from 339 to 387, it paused for a couple of days, then again started trading. So if we look to sell these two options, $380 and $440, it covers for about 1 SD move, and the credit which we are receiving is also decent. It's about 14K. The break-even range is 376 on the downside, which is about 8%, I think. 7% on the downside and 9% on the upside. Now, if we look at IV chart of Ambuja, results, I think, already declared for Ambuja on 23rd July. Yeah. So results are also done with. And if we look at 1 month IBHV chart, I think this is a good enough short trade to take. Ambuja 280, sorry, 380 on the put side and 440 on the call side. Yeah, this is a good enough trade to take. So I might enter a couple of lots here in Ambuja Cement. What else was there? I think Adani I don't want to do because there's a lot of movement in Adani Enterprise. So as you can see that I'm trying to enter this Ambuja Cement ball short trade right now. I've taken a couple of lots puts already, and then call is also kept at 220. This is my order. So let's see. So I'll wait for a couple of minutes. If it doesn't get filled, then I'll put it on 215 or 210. Yeah, I think that's about it. I don't think there are any other all short trades at this moment. I'll try to do this one more time sometime next week. Now, before I conclude this video, these are some of the things I thought I would share with you. I have not shared a setup or a strategy in this video, which you can plug in from tomorrow and start making money. It will take months, if not years, to gain some understanding of this trading style and to make money out of it. So do not just start trading this system from tomorrow onwards. Paper trade, start with paper trading. Identify trades, mark your entries, adjustments, and exits like it was for a real trade, and see the progress before starting to trade the system if you are an inexperienced trader. For experienced ones, it is not advisable to do naked short options for capital which is less than 20 lakhs. If your capital is less than that, then stick to risk-defined trades. I have tried to provide a crisp overview of the thought process that I use before putting in all short trades. There is much more to it that I use in my trading than what I could cover in this video. In terms of trade identification and the trade structures, it's not just the straddles or the strangles that I trade. If there is one key takeaway which you should take from this video, then it should be to sticking to the position size that I have suggested. Make it aggressive, and you never know when can it hurt. Avoid big underlyings that has notional exposure more than 8 lakh when you are starting out. Avoid trading in event-based stocks, say when the earning is due or some other event is around the corner, then avoid trading a wall short in those stocks. Start with non-event-based stocks and then gradually move to earnings-related wall short trade. In case there is a black swan event which can happen anytime, be prepared to lose about 20% of the capital with such position sizing. I have had the win rate of more than 85-90% trading this style, and it goes well with my psychology. I like to keep taking many small gains, a few small loser, and an occasional big loser. So it works well with my psychology. For you, it might or might not work well. So that is something that you have to figure out on your own. With that, good luck to all of you. Happy trading. If you have liked this video, then do let me know your thoughts in comments. Do share and subscribe to the channel if you have not done so already. I'm putting in a lot of efforts in making these videos, and it will keep me motivated. Thanks a lot for watching this. Thank you.